The promises of 3D printing are immense. Imagine that you can take something that only exists in the digital world and bring it right here into reality. This works well at the macroscopic scale, for example, in hobby-grade and industrial applications. But when you want to print at the micro, nano and molecular scale, current technologies still have their limitations.
Well, you basically have two ways how you can manufacture or shape matter. You can subtract material or you can add material. Additive manufacturing is about adding material in the form of voxels or little Lego blocks, if you like. And at the end of the day, this is basically asking for a converter from digital data from a file to some matter you can take in your hands in the real world.
3D Matter Made to Order is a cluster of excellence funded by the German Research Foundation. We are about 200 scientists, both at Heidelberg University and at the Karlsruhe Institute of Technology, pushing the limits of 3D printing.
Our cluster is about driving 3D additive manufacturing towards the small scale, towards the nanometer, towards the molecular scale, and applying that in different areas, including the life sciences and engineering sciences.
We have three interconnected research areas: molecular materials, technologies, and applications.
The main goal of research area A is the design and synthesis of new molecules that later can be printed with the new technologies developed in research area B and applied for different purposes in research area C.
I tackle two main challenges of material science. On one side, the mechanical characterization of the 3D printed microstructures. On the other side, I try to develop more sustainable materials for 3D printing.
My research goal in the cluster was to make 3D laser printing even faster. And to achieve this goal, we needed more sensitive photoresists. To develop these, we had a collaboration with experts in chemistry from the Cluster of Excellence. And in this collaboration, we developed and synthesized new photoinitiator molecules that we could then use for the next generation of 3D laser printing setups.
In research area B, we focus on 3D printing technologies, like for example, laser-based printing technologies, direct laser writing, for example, and deposition-based technologies like inkjet printing or aerosol jet printing. And then we investigate those printed structures by, for example, using electron microscopy.
My first project was inkjet printing of microlens arrays, which can be used for optical systems such as cameras, for example, light field cameras, where we integrate our microlens arrays in it and then we use it for capturing both 3D spatial and spectral information in one snapshot.
One of the things that I work on is printing inorganic materials instead of just polymer materials, which is typically done with laser printing. So now the cluster has helped us with trying to print things that are not just from the liquid phase, but also from other phases of matter, such as gas and things like that, and trying to bring those into a new methodology of printing to allow us to print these inorganic materials.
Research Area C focuses on the applications for which 3D printing technologies and materials have been developed in research areas A and B. And some examples of applications are in the electronic systems, but also for metamaterials or even organotypic systems.
One aspect of my PhD project is to 3D bioprint human vascular cells with the goal of eventually bioprinting vascularized tissue models. One collaboration we have working towards this goal is with a professor at KIT, where we're trying to use electrical fields to stimulate the growth of the vascular structures.
In one of my collaborations, I used this fast 3D laser printing setup to manufacture tailored metamaterials for biological research on cancer cells.
One way the cluster supports us as young scientists is providing interdisciplinary networking opportunities across the different research areas. As a biologist with an interdisciplinary project in a biological institute, without the cluster, I would lack the resources to be able to move my project forward.
As a PI, I find the graduate school tremendously important because it's an environment where the PhD students can meet, can exchange, and learn from each other.
My complete journey as a PhD and now postdoc was fully funded by the Cluster of Excellence. And not only that, Also, the technological devices I needed for this new 3D laser printing setup were paid for by the Cluster of Excellence.
This unique format is something that most people don't get to experience. It's this ability to interact with so many broad different groups of different research fields, from both your PhD and upwards through postdocs and even PIs, being able to have easy access. I wish that I, as a PhD, had been able to participate, but I'm really glad I'm here as a postdoc.
We have been pushing the boundaries of 3D printing for 6 years, but now it's the time to take the next step towards making the promises of 3D printing a reality.
During my PhD, I successfully increased the throughput of 3D laser printing by a factor of 10. But we won't stop at that. We have new ideas coming and currently being developed as we speak that will increase throughput even more than a factor of 10, and maybe even more by a factor of 1 million.
When I look back 7 years and compare that to today, I think we have achieved much more in many regards than we ever hoped for at the time, concerning printing speed, concerning materials that we can work with today. And this is now a fantastic basis to start going into new directions, such as holographic printing, such as inorganic materials and applications in the life sciences.